WD-40.
I missed you all too much. All right, actually, we need to do a little switcheroo here. So, sure, if I can get a little pathway here.
Hope I didn't startle anybody. All right. Oh my goodness. All right, so I got some feet there. All right. Good evening, everyone. I'm Jeremiah, head caretaker of the house. How y'all doing tonight?
Good.
Wonderful. How are you, Miss Eve?
Lovely.
Good. What a nice big group tonight. Fantastic. Well, we're going to show you a little bit more of the house. In order to do that, we're going to switch into smaller groups. We're going to use the pocket doors between the part rooms. It's kind of a rough divide. So you got family or friends? You want to cling to them right now? Or run away? As the case may be, we don't judge at the house, okay?
All right.
Wonderful.
All right.
My group here in the former part room, we're going to be heading upstairs first, all right? to the bedroom level. Best you're going to stay with Miss Eve, you're going to go across the hall over to the library. Then we are going to switch. Everyone's going to see the same things. You're going to hear the same stories, just in a slightly different order. Now, one rule I do have for everyone, as you're going up and down the stairs, do use the handrail, not only for your safety, but because it is the one antique you get to touch. And that's pretty exciting. You're pretty excited about that already, I can tell. Yes, yes. Wonderful, right? So, my group here, you guys ready to go upstairs, see a bit more of the house?
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah, maybe two to stick behind, just to eat out a group a little more. Okay.
Wonderful, all right. And the rest of you staying with Miss Eve, well, good luck.
Hey, I've never lost a group.
Right. Yes. Oh, we're going with him.
Yep. Once I know it's safe, I'll be going upstairs.
You're going upstairs.
Y'all see anything? No, roll down.
Okay.
We're going upstairs, and I am first. Wait a minute. Oh, God, my hand trembling. It smells. Oh, my gosh. Okay, here we go. Oh, gosh. It's freezing in this room.
People
oh my gosh, look at that.
They had six kids.
Look at that dog.
Oh my gosh, look. I don't know.
Come up here whenever it's safe.
Oh my gosh, look at that room right there. That's a pretty bed.
Got wallpaper. I didn't know they had wallpaper back then.
Yeah, they have wallpaper back there. Y'all see anything? Y'all let me know.
I don't feel nice.
All right, now, folks, if you'll pardon me, I'm just going to make my way to the other end of the hallway here. I've got a couple of stories to tell you. You are going to get a chance to glance in the room, take some pictures if you like. If you want to multitask and take pictures as I'm speaking, feel free to do that as well. And I'm just going to make my way into here, but pardon me, folks, that's okay. I'm going to try to get to this corner right here as best I can. Thank y'all so much. So this is the bedroom floor. It's the second story of the Angelo house. We've got five bedrooms upstairs. You also have this bathroom, which was part of the original design of the house by the architect John Norris. Now, the bedrooms are named after people who spent the most or the most memorable time in each. For instance, this is the Lowe bedroom. It's named for both Mary Lowe and Juliet Gordon Lowe. Now, the women in the family seem to have been drawn to this room more than any other. Unfortunately, this means that a lot of women have died in this room. Mary Stiles Lowe actually passed away in that bed in 1863. Juliet Gordon Lowe, well, she died in 1927, sitting at a desk. These would be there in the corner by one of the windows overlooking Lafayette Square. Now, it's those two deaths in particular that might be the reason why this room seems to exude a certain unhappiness. It's not all the time, but when tragedies and circumstances call for it, definitely is a sense of despair that can come from here. Now, during the hurricane season of 1979, after one of the more severe storms, a couple ladies from the society showed up to assess the damage. They had to unshutter the windows, move some sandbags, and when they got here, they heard what sounded like muffled crying. Now, both these ladies are very no-nonsense. Figured someone probably broke into the house seeking shelter from the storms. They came in to investigate. They came inside, up the stairs, and down the hall. The crying just got louder and louder, till they got here to the threshold of the low bedroom. By now, the crying is so loud, they're trying to find its source, but not a soul to be found. The house was deserted after all. The crying didn't weaken. The women began to feel the sense of sadness, almost like a wave of depression washing over them. And to escape that feeling, they actually fled, ran right out of the house. A couple weeks later, staff realized not only had the house been shuttered and survived the storm, but the day that they heard the crying was actually the anniversary of the death of Mary Little, which is June 17th. It's always my day off. Pardon me, make my way this way, please.
I'm sorry.
Did she die in there? Gorgeous.
It's freezing up here.
Mary Lowe?
That bed is so
pretty. No, some patients from childbirth.
Childbirth. And the woman at the desk?
That was more natural causes. That's Julia Gordon, though. Yes. Over here, this is the Styles bedroom. Right? Named for Eliza Styles, who was Mary's mother. Of course, Mary was Andrew's second wife. And after Mary died, Eliza moved in to help take care of the children, which is why her bedroom is directly across from the nursery. So, although it's named for Eliza, it is another spirit to be seen in this room. We believe the spirit of that of Colonel William Heaviside, Eliza's husband, Mary's father. Now, Colonel Fowles had served during the Civil War. He became very ill and was brought here to the house to convalesce. Unfortunately, in 1865, he contracted pneumonia, and he died in this room. Now, we had a housekeeper who used to work here. She would start out at the basement level of the house, work her way up to this floor. And as she would tidy up in the hall, she would glance into this bedroom, and she would see the figure of a man on that rocking chair. She called the figure Mr. Lowe, but we don't think it was Andrew. And even the housekeeper agreed, it really didn't look like Andrew Lowe. Now, given that Colonel Stiles was a sickly man who died in the room, it makes more sense that spectral form would be him, rocking away his final hours over and over again. Now, as promised, have a glance in the room, take some pictures if you like. Photography is highly encouraged. Just make sure your flash is off. I'll point out the other rooms to you real quick. This is the Robert E. Lee bedroom up here. Now, Robert E. Lee did not die in this house. He did spend some time here. This, again, is the children's bedroom or children's nursery. Officially, I'm not supposed to say those dolls look creepy, but you can look at that, make that judgment for yourself, okay? And then over here in the corner is the Thackeray bedroom, named for the author William Makepeace Thackeray. So please have a look around, take some pictures. I'll be able to answer any questions that I can.
It's so cold up here.
But
this bed here is so pretty. Y'all stop, Cardi. I'm gonna bust the shit out you. Stupid ass.
Now, if y'all wondering what is behind the closed door over here, the original was an extension.
Who ringing the damn bell?
Of course, today is the survival item in the house.
Who ringing the bell?
Now, we didn't hear a bell. Bell does toll for me. So that's our cue to head on upstairs to the more of the house. Get your last books, your last pictures, and we'll head all downstairs.
Wait a minute. You heard that?
What?
Yeah, what was that?
I don't know what the hell that was.
It was an Annabelle.
No, it was like somebody saying something. Yeah. You heard it? No, I promised the God.
Shut up. You know me. You got to be together anyway. I don't know.
Do you hear it?
I heard something.
It was like somebody saying something.
This ain't a ghost tour for nothing.
Did y'all set that up?
No.
For a child to just say something just then? Oh my God. Come on, son, let's go.
You gonna look at that live video when we get home?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to look at the video when I get home. Let's go. Let's go, because I know what I heard.
I know I'm
not
crazy. My damn,
something
burned the hell out of my leg.
I know what I heard. It sounded like it said, ooh, something burnt my leg burning. We're going to listen to the video when we get home because I know I heard a kid voice. Something, my leg is burning. What's wrong?
Skeleton key.
Oh, not all the way back.
They already in there talking.
They in there. We can't go in now.
I don't think we're allowed to. Get the picture, man.
What was that? I did hear something.
Cardi's so stupid. Shh, damn it. What's this here? Oh, this must be where the slave was. Slave court. I'm not going downstairs.